Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Laurence Plays Factorio Angel Bobs. So, this is going to be a rather odd episode, I'm afraid, because it turns out after recording episode 27, I realised that I'd actually been recording the wrong monitor and therefore had absolutely nothing to, apart from the background sound of my narration to go with it. So, rather than uploading an hour or half an hour of a nice view of my recording software with Factorio noises and me blathering away in the background, I thought I'd just give you a quick summary of what I did in that episode, and then try and move on to a slightly more sensibly done one. After the rather badly failed attempt at dealing with the biters down to the south in order to get hold of those iron patches in the previous episode, I went out there again and had another go at it, and I was a bit more successful this time. I managed to clear out the bases that were the nests that were over here in this sort of area, and I then went over here to attack the other ones. I was doing sort of okay at it, but it was still even with without the alcohol hindering my driving, it was still not going brilliantly. So I eventually decided that enough was enough, and I started doing a bit of turret creep. So down here, nice wall with some turrets on it. Then down here, I built up a larger stack of turrets to get rid of the nest that was in this space here. Or no, it must have been about here, actually. and then some more down here on the corner to protect against any attacks from this one. But I didn't actually go out and kill that, as you can see, because it's still there. I also worked my way along here, again, building up the wall as it was. And I wiped out the nests that were here, with a bit of turret creep that I think probably just came down from here, and then I demolished it to move on, because these turrets don't have enough range to get all the way down there, so I must have cleared them out some other way. And then, as always, I just built the turret wall over here. Yeah, it turns out some of the coloured spitters are a bit more dangerous than I was really ready for. Let's see if I can find some. So, what we've got here is spitters that have different attacks. So here we have the huge explosive spitter. So I think they just fire, not surprisingly, they fire explosive spits, for want of a better word. And I think they had splash damage, because there were a couple of times when I had inserters and belts damaged behind the front lines. These ones, electric ones, okay. And acid spitters. Maybe it was the acid spitters that had the scatter damage, I'm not sure. But there was one of them as well that I discovered fired homing projectiles. They're not quite as bad as the homing projectiles in the older beta versions, where they sort of just chase you forever and there's no way to escape them. If you got out of range, then they would eventually just hit the floor harmlessly, but as long as you were in range of them, they'd just sort of follow you around and eventually hit you. I also noticed that we've got, as well as the big worms and spitters, big biters. So we had these blue ones before, these are big biters. We now seem to also be getting the huge ones, which is like this one, huge, and that's an acidic biter. I don't even know what that is. I imagine they just do more damage in various weird and interesting ways. So, and these are the huge spitters as well. So we've moved on and up another tier in enemy types. As part of this, I lost another two cars and died again. So it didn't go quite as well as I hoped, really. But I did eventually manage to defeat all of the enemies down here. And as you can see, I built up these two mines and stations completely. So these ones are now running merrily there. As you can see, they're loading the chests up and ready to load a train as soon as it pulls in. And the same down here. I also built this one up as well. I haven't run power out to it yet, and I haven't finished off the railway because I ran out of railway lines, so I gave up and went off and did something else for a bit. So yeah, there was a lot of turret creep in defending this area, which I feel a little bit not guilty about, because you know it's a game, play it however you like, but I do still feel it's a little bit cheesy to go out like that and use turret creep against the biters, especially as I'm playing with the long reach mod. Although that said, it was all belt fed turret creep, so I wasn't just dropping a turret in the middle of the nest, some ammunition in it, and then holding a repair pack on it. It was sort of gradually creep towards and building up an actual defensible position, so that's a bit better perhaps. One of the other things I did, as you might notice here, there's an obvious gap where there's red ammunition going down here and yellow across here. That's because I set up something somewhere along here, I forget exactly where, and I think I've got rid of it now as well. I set up a filter splitter to pull out all of the yellow ammunition and dump it in a box, and I then took it up and put it into the ammunition factory up here. So a lot of these have got a lot of spare ammunition in them now, which is why at least some of them aren't pulling iron off this belt at the moment, because they're still full of ammunition. Yeah, you see, this one's got 153 in, because so I dumped it all there to make so it all so that the resources wouldn't be wasted. So I then started building cars on the bus down here with yes, here we go. So I reckon that since I was building engines here for the locomotives, I might as well use some of those engines to build cars as well. So they're getting dumped into so there should always be a car waiting for me in this box, and that makes it a bit easier. It means I don't have to faff around with the system I had up here that was very, very manual. I also then did a bit of research. I picked up let's have a look at the bottom here. I picked up cargo bots and logistics bots and a few other things to go with them. In the theory that I might not be quite ready for them yet, but at least if I've got them researched, then it's gets me a step closer. I also researched cargo robots, which are an angels thing, and I've not really looked into those very much yet. I don't know if they're going to be useful. I get the impression they might be quite good for transporting large quantities of stuff over long distances, but not so much for just keeping things supplied and replenished like a belt or just me demanding stuff because I'm running around looking for things. So as I mentioned, I've got the railways in down here. This is all... apparently there's a gap in the railway there. I should fix that as well. But generally this is working nicely. Because I added these extra two mines here, I needed some way of making sure I didn't have... the trains didn't block this line when they're waiting to unload. So I built up the stacker here. And as you can see, I've got one train in the station being unloaded, and then another two waiting here. So I can support up to four mines, and even if I don't have any iron being used at the time, which, to be honest, I'm not far off at the moment. This is very, very quiet now. As long as I don't have more than four trains trying to unload at any one time, then it's going to be okay. I'm not going to have any problems with the trains getting stacked up on the line here and blocking the other trains that are trying to come through this system. I think that's basically everything I did, to be honest. it turns out clearing out biters and building up mines is surprisingly time consuming. So I spent quite a lot of time working on that dealing with the learning about the colourful biters. I think I probably put down some more of this brickwork, but I'm not quite sure. That might have been in the next episode, which I recorded before I realised that I'd messed up the previous one, and so I don't really have access to what the map looked like at the end of the previous episode. That was episode number 27. It was a bit of a screw up. I do apologise for everyone who was desperately waiting to watch me in martial action out against the biters again once again. However, hopefully you've seen enough of that over the other previous episodes, and it's not like it's going to be the last time I go out fighting them. So there'll be plenty more chances for that. There'll also be plenty more chances for me building up things at random and hopefully and trying to get things working. So I hate to say it, but you've probably not missed an enormous amount. But I do hope you'll come back to watch the next episodes and see where it went from there. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.